Welcome to The Wrap. I'm Gene Wong. Joining me today to discuss the Washington Redskins 49-27 loss to the Indianapolis Colts is Dan Steinberg of the DC Sports Blog. Dan, the Redskins' fourth straight loss. Colt McCoy, the starting quarterback, that's obviously going to be the water cooler conversation, but we do our takeaways from the top. And from my perspective, Colt McCoy acquitted himself much better than Griffin has this season. The offense moved along. After that first quarter, that was a disaster, played fine the rest of the way. I mean, McCoy made a few poor decisions here and there, like that throw to Jordan Reed in the end zone, but that probably would have really impacted the outcome of the game. But McCoy's final stats, 31 for 47, 392 yards, three touchdowns, no turnovers, most importantly. And Jordan Reed got in the game. DeSean Jackson was part of the game plan. So from that point of perspective, they look fine. But, you know, the defense, again, just didn't hold up its end. What did you see as a takeaway from this game?
You know, I think we knew probably going into this game that the Redskins weren't a good football team. I think that we also know, at least right now, they're not a very well-coached football team. I think you see that a lot of different ways. There's the penalties. There seemed to be a general state of confusion on both sides of the ball, especially on the defense, where repeated miscommunications leaving guys totally wide open. You've got, like, I think three fourth downs that the Redskins went for. I don't know that I'd necessarily agreed with at least two of the decisions, and they didn't convert any of the key fourth downs. I think they just... Jay Gruden doesn't really seem like a man who's in command leading this team in the right direction. As of right now, obviously, things change quickly in the NFL, but they weren't well coached today.
Well, you mentioned the first fourth down, and the one I think everyone's going to be talking about is the first one, fourth and less than a yard. And they try to play action, which I thought, you know, was a good decision, but the backside wasn't blocked. Waldron comes in and trucks McCoy and forces the fumble.
That was, that was a fourth down I thought they should go for, but there's a difference between thinking they should go for it and thinking they should leave an exposed quarterback to get sacked. You know,
But at this point of the season, what do they stand to lose? I mean, you're not going to the playoffs, right? You're not trying to make a push to get a home field advantage. So you might as well take some chances, right? I mean, is that the worst decision in the world?
I totally agree with you. And obviously we saw later when they were trying to run on second and third and short near the goal line that their short running game is not necessarily great either. I just think that was a play where there was a man who was running free. There did not seem to be an obvious plan to block him unless it was Alfred Morris who's supposed to fake getting the ball
and then go the other way. That could not have been the protection.
And there was
scheme.
A timeout right before that play for them to think about it, too.
Yeah. Okay. Well, let's move on to studs and duds. And since it's a loss, we start off with the duds. Who do you got, Dan?
And, you know, I'm going to go to the other side of Jay Gruden, Jay Gruden's defensive coaching peer. I'm going to give it to Jim Haslett, who's been a punching bag for years. But I don't know that it gets much worse than it did on this day. Obviously, Andrew Luck, probably a future Hall of Famer, but still, he's 19 of 27 for 370 yards. But look at all of the touchdowns that came on long plays and blown coverages. Fleener from 30, Fleener from 73, Heron a 49-yard run, Moncrief from 48, Moncrief from 79.
Sure.
I understand the secondary has been battered by injuries. I understand that. You've got some young guys back there. But at some level, when they're one long touchdown pass after another to guys that just have no defenders anywhere around them, I think that's got to be on Jim Haslett, so I'm giving him the dud today.
Well, and it's also an indictment that they gave up 27 points at home coming off a bye to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, which were 1-8, too.
Yeah, and much less the 29 points at Minnesota with Teddy Bridgewater looking terrible, they still scored 29. There's been a lot of bad defensive performances this year.
Well, there was a few good offense performances, and my stud is going to be Jordan Reed. Jordan Reed had 9 catches for 123 yards in his first game back from a sore hamstring after sitting out last week. And he changes that offense so much, don't you think? I mean, he when you have two guys on the outside like Pierre Garçon and Sean Jackson, if you take those away and you have just a guy like Jordan Reed who's able to get coverage matchup, he's a matchup nightmare over the middle. The Colts had difficulty covering him. I mean, it makes a huge difference. Now with Deshaun Jackson out, I mean, I don't know, maybe he becomes more involved in the offense. I mean, what do you see there?
He certainly looked good, and this was, you know, coming back from injury, which he's battled repeatedly this season. Yeah. But, you know, that comes kind of at the expense of Garcon, who I think only had 3 or 4 catches today. So at some point, it's about getting the ball in the end zone and not just 9 catches up the middle of the field.
Right. Well, Dan, thanks for your insight today. Remember, the Redskins play the St. Louis Rams, who just beat, by the way, the Oakland Raiders 52-0. So we'll be talking about that a lot coming up this week. For Dan Steinberg, I'm Gene Wong. Thanks for watching The Wrap. We'll see you next time.